Hey guys, so in this video, I'm going to do a game recap of game 4 of the Hawks versus Bucks in Atlanta. If you want more content like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe and comment if you have any other thoughts. So let's get into it. So I thought it was a fairly entertaining game, well, at least up until Giannis got hurt in the third quarter. So you hate to see that, so hopefully he gets to come back healthy relatively soon. And I was really curious in this game to see how the Hawks would respond to playing without Trae Young, especially because of his injury. And they responded really well. They had great energy and were clearly prepared. So hats off to Nate McMillan there. Lou Williams especially got off to a great start. He actually scored 7 of the first 15 points for the Hawks. And so on the Bucks side, PJ Tucker got off to a really good start. You saw him shooting pretty well, especially given that he's been only shooting around 30% from three from the playoffs so far. And then because of the injuries, you saw Cam Reddish and Chris Dunn get a lot of playoff minutes, especially early in the game. Reddish especially, I thought, played very well and was a very major part of the win. He actually scored 5 for 9 for 12 points, and maybe most importantly, his really great defense on Chris Middleton. Chris Middleton, he only shot 6 for 17 for 17 points, so he was very inefficient, and I think that's kind of the story for him. Like, I think Chris Middleton is a really good player, especially because he's a two-way player, and I think sometimes he's just inconsistent at times. A lot of times he would give you superstar-like performances and you think he's like a max contract player and he hits game-winning shots as he did against Miami. However, some games he would give you games like these where he's shooting 6 for 17 and he's inefficient. So that's why I really do believe that how far the Bucks are able to go is going to really depend on how Chris Middleton plays. And of course, they're going to need Giannis healthy, but Chris Middleton is a really big factor for them, especially because he really operates as their closer. And so in this first quarter, it really seemed like they were shooting a lot of threes. Even with Trae Young out, they were still really chucking it up. Like, the Hawks shot about 12 threes in the first quarter and the Bucks shot 14. And in this first quarter, this was actually the first time that Giannis did not score in a quarter for a pretty long time. So that was significant. He was just not having a good game early on. And so in the second quarter, I started to realize that even like with Trae Young out, the Hawks were able to really move the ball well. Like, the ball wasn't really sticking in anyone's hands. I guess partially because they didn't have like a star player in the court. So they were really just trying to play team ball, and it worked really well for them. They got a lot of open shots and good looks. And I think in this quarter, Onyeka Okongwu was really playing well. He was making himself available in the paint, and he was playing with really great energy, actually. And then just Lou Williams was the story of this quarter as well, as he was the entire game. There was a stretch where he actually got an offensive rebound, like as a really short guard. And he also did a fadeaway over Giannis. Which is really incredible. And then overall, Lou Williams was actually a perfect 4-for-4 for 13 first half points. So again, yeah, he was a story for like the entire game. And then on the Bucks side of things, really sort of their big three wasn't playing too well. And Giannis especially was very, it seemed like he was very passive. And he wasn't really getting to the line much either. And when he did get to the line, man, he really shot really poorly. He actually had 2 air balls in the first half on the free throw line. And it really makes me wonder, like, if we had the Sixers versus the Bucks in the conference finals, like, it would just turn into a free throw shooting match. However, in the third quarter, Giannis clearly was more aggressive, and he was able to make a lot of points in the paint. He didn't settle for fadeaways. And honestly, I'm kind of surprised the Hawks didn't send him to the line. But credit to Giannis there. He did really well. Up until he He got hurt in the middle of the third quarter with a left knee hyperextension. And from then on, the Hawks really just took a control. Basically, they went on a 12-2 run after Giannis was hurt. And from there on, the game was just kind of over for the Bucks. They just really weren't able to come up with enough to get back in the game. And I thought some other players worth mentioning were, first of all, Kevin Huerter. I thought, especially at the end of the shot clock, he was able to create offense. And overall, he was just very in control, and he clearly has a really good shot. And another player that played well was Danilo Gallinari. He hit threes earlier in the game, and later in the game, he actually played in the post, and he ended up with 10 points, and I thought he played really well. I thought Bobby Portis played with really good energy, and I think that's kind of his calling card in the sense that he just really plays with a lot of energy. He's always there, but in this game, he did only shoot 1 for 5 from three. And especially with how good of a shooter he's been in the regular season, I think he really needs to do a better job. PJ Tucker got off to a really good start and overall shot 2 for 5 from three. And he played really good defense, especially against John Collins. You know, PJ Tucker, he's giving up inches against John Collins for sure. Definitely not the tallest player, but he's really strong. And he was really able to play well against Collins. And Collins overall did not have the best game. He only shot 2 for 8 for only 4 points. So for the next game, I mean, you really hope that Trae Young and Giannis are able to come back healthy and hopefully have a quick recovery. You hate to see injuries at any level. And I think that especially this year's playoffs has been really riddled with injuries. So definitely hope that they could come back soon and come back healthy. And I think for the Bucks, I think what they can do to improve is firstly, either Chris Middleton or Drew Holiday needs to have a good game. And I think really their bench players need to show up more. I think in this game, their bench players didn't really give them too much. So if the Bucks can get good production from them, I really think they have a much better shot at winning the next game. So those were my observations for the game. If you disagree or you have something to add, please comment down below. If you like content like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.